All right, we're off to the races. Here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Moody Monday. Show 404 in the Spirit Elevator Studio. This is our last show. Hey, Donnell. Hey, Laura Deeds. Hey, Tony Phoenix. Thanks for checking in live. This is our last show in this basement. Okay? But we are moving. Always moving up. Always moving up. So we're moving up. We'll be moving on up to the East Granby side. Okay. So yeah, the Spirit Elevator is finding another home. We'll be there next week. We already started our moving. We got the garage loaded up. We're ready to move on in. And everything in here is pretty much all that's left of the house. Hold on. I forgot to turn my radio down over there. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Hold on a second. Oh, criminy. Crappity, criminy. Criminy, crappity. Okay. Holy moly. There we go. Okay. Turn your radio down, caller. You think I'd get that down by now? Okay. So, what a trip it's been, huh? You want to do... Let's do our theme song. Wait. Did my gavel get packed? Nope, it's right down here. All right. Let us commence the show for the evening. Here we go. We're going to give it a nice reverb-y commencement here on the right here on the microphone. Ladies and gentlemen, gather around for our Monday evening AA Acoustics Anonymous meeting commenced. Thank you. And now, let's get to the meeting. All right. Laura Deeds, what a trip it's been. Laura Deeds has been here since the beginning of these shows. A few years ago. We've come a long way. Back then I used to just set up the phone on a stick and I'd have a Tambo toe between my toe, under my feet. But now check it out. This is how we rock it now. All I had on yesterday. Today I got to thinking I may not live to see another day. So I spend all my monies on today. Out tomorrow if I'm still here, oh, what a sorry fellow I'll be. For I'll have nothing left to spend on me. Somehow I stayed alive through all this crazy shit I've seen. And it sure is nice to see you all again. And I'm gonna sing a song for you. And Bill's gonna show you a thing or two. Bill, stop showing him that thing. All right, we're back. Indeed, yeah, that's right, Donnell, we have liftoff. All right, so we've been looking back at some of the songs. I have my filing cabinet right over there. What's up there, Steve Cutler? Thanks for checking in live. All right. So I unloaded the file cabinet, which had all our songs. Like, well, of course, we have the Spirit Elevator songbook. I made these up maybe a year and a half ago to bring to the music festivals that we play live. We bring the Spirit Elevator here to, we'll be bringing it again to the Strange Creek Music Festival. And so we bring these books so people can have like common ground. And, you know, we can kind of look through here. If you can't think of a tune that everybody knows, there's songs in here that everybody kind of knows. And you can read along with the lyrics and the chords. So, you know, even if you don't know the song too well, you can join in and play along. So that's something that came about over the last few years. Some people don't know about the origin of the name Spirit Elevator. And that came from, you guys all know Emma Kales on the fiddle. Our good friend Emma, she'll be back on the show again. We'll get settled back in and have guests like we used to do too once we get settled into the new place. Yeah, the original spirit name Spirit Elevator came from Emma and I were playing at the, there was a festival that our buddy Shannon Splackett used to run. And Joel was a big part of that. All our friends in Team Northeast that organized festivals. Well, they organized this festival in an old, like, what would you call it? You know the hotel in Dirty Dancing? It's kind of like that. It's sort of like a mix between the hotel in Dirty Dancing and the hotel in The Shining. Because it was like, it probably used to be like the hotel in Dirty Dancing, but that was a long time ago. And you know, the place was kind of hurting, and they were hurting for business too. So what our friends did is they took over this resort hotel in the Catskill Mountains, Kerhonks in New York. And they had Max Creek played there, a bunch of big bands. Dumpster Funk played there. There's a lot of good bands that played there, and a lot of musicians I met at those shows. And we would have our Upright, of course. Hey, Mary. So yeah, I had the Upright bass there, and Emma, of course, had her fiddle. And I ran one of the more acoustic-y stages throughout the weekend. And when that was shut, you know, when that was done for the night, we'd be walking around playing our instruments. We were looking for people to play jam with, you know, late at night. Like the Black Crowes song. Round here we stay up. We stayed up very, 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 very late. And it was around, it was probably 2:30 in the morning at this point. And we were like, where the heck can we go where people are still going to be up and wanting to hear some music? We said, the elevator. All right. So we brought the upright bass into the elevator of this resort hotel. And she brought her fiddle in. It was a medium-sized elevator. And we just took it over. And it was great. We were up and down, up and down, up and down for about 5 hours on that thing. People were smoking butts and weed and drinking booze and whatever. And that was the craziest elevator ride. it put that Willy Wonka elevator to shame. But yeah, we had a good time on the elevator for like 5 hours. And then that became like a tradition to do that. And later that summer, they were doing Camp Creek. And Derek Kipp, who was you know, kind of putting together the music for it, he sent me a message. He goes, oh, I'd like to have you guys, you know, do that, like the roaming thing. You guys can be, you know, an extra act that just kind of plays out in the, you know, for the morale of the troops, you know, we could just play out in the fields there. I said, yeah, we could do that, man. He goes, well, do you have a name for the act? And I thought about it for a bit. I wanted to incorporate elevator somehow. You know, it's like the Spirit Elevators. And I just love like the double or triple entendre you can use with that name. You know, the Spirit Elevators, you know. I usually think of it as like, you know, raising your spirits, the Spirit Elevators. But you could raise a glass, like your spirits, you know, like in the, we call our you know, the booze in the liquor store here in New England. We call them the spirits. You know, you could raise your spirits. You could raise the dead, you know, raise those spirits, the Spirit Elevator. So, yeah, so it really stuck, and I loved it, and kind of made it our identity here, especially for Moody Mondays. we'll lift you up. I tell you what, since we just mentioned that, let's do some songs like, let's open with Give, and then I'm going to do Whippoorwill, which was Josh Rosberg's song, buddy of ours, Josh, great musician friend that we lost this year. I'd like to play his song for you. Maybe I'll do a couple Big Mike songs. And, you know, some of the ones that were, some of the bigger tunes that we did that we all got a kick out of down here over the last few years. And, the title on there was, I apologize for the teaser title that said it's our last show. It's our last show here. All right. We play music on this show. Let's do it. Give. Oh, this one's got to go out to my mother. It's my mother's birthday today. So I'm kind of thinking about my mom quite a bit today. I know it's April Fool's, which was convenient because we never really had to get her anything. I just got her an empty box year after year. That's not true. We used to do, I was telling Noel about, we used to do breakfast in bed for my mom. We were probably like 6 years old or something, I was probably like 6 years old trying to make breakfast in bed for her. It was always ridiculous, you know. She appreciated it. She's like, oh, this is so sweet. Like, you need more orange juice? She's like, no, it's everywhere. And like, there were, you know, stack of pancakes up to here. And the ratios and portions were all off. But the sentiment was off the charts. Okay. So, yeah, I miss my mom too, Mary. She was awesome. Some of the kids would call her Mrs. Cleaver, like almost as a goof. Like, and if you're familiar with the show Leave It to Beaver, the mother was Mrs. Cleaver. And I don't know how that could be any sort of an insult, man. She was the best. Like, Mrs. Cleaver was on it. Like, she, you know, she, so I wouldn't, I really got lucky with my mom's. So, all right. My mom was a dietary aide in high school. Yes, a lunch lady. She picked up a job when we were in high school, so the kids were, you know, once we were kind of old enough to be out, she was, you know, she picked up a job during the day, and she got a job at the high school. And my mom was the most honest person. She would never. Never cheat or you know, she'd wait at the red light if there was nobody around at 11 p.m. you know, she was very honest and a great, great woman. But she had a job working as a dietary aide, don't call me a lunch lady, at our high school. And we would get, you know, I would pile up the plate, and you know, I get two chicken burgers, you know, chicken patty day. Oh, that was the best. I'm going to scoop out the rice with the ice cream scooper, put it on there, and get my tray over there. And I give her the $2 for the lunch. And she'd smile back and she goes, "Oh, thank you." And she'd give me back like 8 quarters, you know. I was like, "Oh, thanks," you know. So, yeah, she hooked me up with the free lunch every day. And she figured that was like the least that they could do, you know. She's like, "Well, I'm working here. My son goes to school. We pay taxes. He's going to get his free lunch." So she hooked me up. I passed it forward. Is that what they say? Yeah, I passed it forward to all my friends. You know, I'd get that extra cookie on there. Share it around with the friends at the table. All right. So I wrote this song for my mom. A song called Give. I wrote this for my mom and a few other friends that kind of left us too soon. And that's what this song is about. It's kind of a celebration of life here. Life is to give, not to take. Nice. I'm going to start it over, though. I started playing the drum, and I messed up, and I'd like to get a good version of this down. Hold on. Okay. Give. Take two. We'll fix it in post. Elevator joke.
Time keeps adding to my mind. Bring back reason, bring back rhyme. If you knew how much I cared, time would vanish in the air. Back when you were still alive, back when I was making time. It's been a few years, but we're moving on. It's been a few years since you've been gone, and still not a single day goes by as you don't come back to my mind. Life is to give, not to take. I've done my time, forgive my mistakes. 10 years in the galley I had to endure. Pursue me no more. You can take a trip through time, if you could go back in your mind. sparks light the midnight sky. A fiery laugh brings a tear to my eye. Like a great big boom before dead silence, or a moment of peace before breakout of violence. A blinding flash that went out too soon, like a harvest in the middle of June. A tree and buds were not in bloom. A life that came to an end too soon. It's still not a single day goes by if you don't sing your songs in my mind. Love is to give, not to take. I've done my time, forgive my mistake. 10 years in the galley I had to endure. Let me live, assume me no more. Love is to give, not to take. The letter of law does not justice make. 10 years in the galley I had to endure. Let me live, assume me no more. Oh, 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 oh. Yes.
All right. All right, so we're off to a start here. I said I'd like to do this one by Josh Rosberg. Song called Whippoorwill. Hello there, Aaron Earth, checking in live on the live chat. Big Dan checking in live. A little say hello to Dan and Joshy Poo over there. Over in Rhode Island, in the roadie, out there, say hello to our friends in the roadie. Oh, you guys hearing that? I'm getting some, oh. It's this guy. Oh, sorry about that. Huh. I wonder what that was. That was weird. We got ghosts in the gear. That was a new one. Yeah, a little crackle. A little snap, crackle, and pop. Hey there, Pop. Yeah. He's not dying. The microphone's not dying. He's just hungry. The piano has been drinking. You know that song? Who's that? Tom Waits. Hey there, Evan. That's Evan. You can say hi to Evan there, Telecontar. Nice. Yeah, I don't know what happened. I unplugged it and plugged it back in. And that seems to work sometimes, you know. Sometimes you just got to turn it off. Wait 10 seconds. I waited about 3 seconds. And it seemed to do the trick. I don't know. You know, in fact, that's what I'm going to... I write that. Bob Weir, what's up? That's Martha. Checking in on the chat. I'm just pointing out who's here on the chat. Yeah, in fact, I put that in my, I got a little, instead of a do not resuscitate, no, I put a little, addendum on the do not resuscitate. I said, well, you know, if I'm lying there hooked up to a machine keeping me alive, I want you to at least try unplugging it for about 10 seconds and plug it back in and see if that works, you know? Before you finally give up. GT, that looks like Glenn Talbot. Hey, hey. Hey now. Hey now, Mr. Talbot. Maybe we'll do a Max Creek song for you and for Tony. You want to hear Archer tonight? Tony's got a request. Yeah, if you got any requests, be happy to consider them. All right. Let me get some songs in. This one was written by our friend Josh Rosberg. He was on the show. I had him over to the house. I don't know, probably a couple of years ago by now. And unfortunately, he passed away last year. And it was sad. It's always sad to lose somebody, especially unexpectedly like that. So I like to keep his music alive. And this is one of his songs called Whippoorwill. I'd like to share this one with you guys. And Josh Rosberg, thank you for the music.
Everybody's got a hold of their machines. They've got them in their hands, cooking up the master plans. Get on out, live their lives like magazines and never take a stand. Purchase things that they don't need. I don't live that way. You don't either. Let's be friends and we can seize the day. Make a little getaway and run to the hills. Light a fire with the magazines and dance around the flames. Like we are from an ancient scene on a tapestry from a long lost century. Hung on the wall in a palace of the queen. Summertime, if you're inclined. If you're lonely and feel like I do, come rest your bones with me. Visit the still, sit and listen to the whippoorwill, singing a sweet sad song. I won't lie to you. All my lying days are done. Now I wanna tell the truth. Even if the truth is a loaded gun, baby, if the truth be told, I know you're only in my mind an incarnation of the queen of summertime. And when the summer ends and the leaves all start to change, we'll start the process, hearts all rearrange. When the cold reminds, if you're inclined. If you're lonely and feel like I do, come rest your bones with me. Visit the still, sit and listen to the whippoorwill, singing a sweet sad song. If you're lonely and feel like I do, come rest your bones with me. Visit the still, sit and listen to the whippoorwill, singing a sweet sad song. Like I do, come rest your bones with me. Visit the still, sit and listen to the whippoorwill, singing a sweet sad song. If you're lonely and feel like I do, come rest your bones with me.
Oh, thanks, Glenn. All right, we're going to do Archer for Tony Phoenix here. I was just thinking about the videos we made for some of these tunes. We're getting back into making some other ones. We got some good footage from the last from our most recent trip to New Mexico. We're going to use a lot of that, the footage for Noel's new song, Palindromio, which we're finishing up recording. So yeah, one of our first videos I made was this one for Archer, and I took the video camera up to East Hampton. There's a wildlife sanctuary called Acadia Wildlife Sanctuary in East Hampton, Mass. And I brought this camera up there, and you know, took a long walk around. I went back a few times actually, checking in on the comments here. Sorry, I got distracted. Himfo55 says, sounds good through the TV and the system. Thank you for checking in. Yeah, so I took the camera up to Acadia Wildlife Sanctuary in East Hampton, and was just hoping to get some wildlife footage, kind of. And yeah, that's in Glenn Talbot's backyard. And I'm walking along the trail. I kind of see something move over here off to the side. It's a little white tail. It's like, oh yeah, there he is. Little deer over there. I kind of crept over to him, and I was able to get fairly close. I set up the camera and everything. Got a decent shot at this guy. But my heart was racing. I was like, oh, this is awesome. So then I spent the rest of the day just kind of walking deeper into the woods. And sure enough, I found a whole bunch of deer because they know they're safe in this area. I was joking that the deer at the wildlife sanctuary walk around with their lawyers just waiting for someone to take a shot, you know? All right. That's Randy Macho Man Savage checking in. All right, I got you. So I was able to get some really wild shots of these deer up in the sanctuary. And then Noelle and I had fun with that one. She got a deer costume for that video. She dressed up as a little deer, and I was like, go in the thicket over there. She got into the little brush. And we got some video of Noelle playing her mandolin like a wild deer in the shrubs. But yeah, we had a good time making this one. You can check, the videos are on our King Sazen page. Well, they're also on the Jeff. I put them up on Jeff King Live here too, but you can see those videos on the King Sazen page too. All right, so here we go. Archer for Tony. Oh yeah, we start out like this.
Partner, my friend, will you be my archer? Will you take out all of my enemies? As through the fog I cannot see, will you watch the tree line till daylight? Protect me while I sleep tonight. My friend, will you carry this load for me? Just a few more days and then I'll take it back with you. Up my strength again. I'm counting who I count as friends. Can I count you out or count you in? That's how I fall, but together we win. Myself, I need your love, I need your help. Through all the sickness and through health, we can share the joys and we can share the wealth. My friend, will you be my partner? My friend, will you be my archer? Will you take out all of my enemies? Through the fog I cannot see, will you watch the tree line till daylight? Protect me while I sleep tonight.
Tune called Archer there. A lot of these songs, I wrote a lot of songs over the last couple of years since we started the Spirit Elevator Show. That's one of them. But yeah, definitely the show inspired a lot of new music and a lot of new friendship. Oh, it inspired a new love. Yeah, remember I had Noelle over for the first time. Of course, we had known each other a little bit in the music scene. And then it was I invited her over to do a Spirit Elevator show. Back when during COVID, a lot of people were coming over. That's right. Laura Deeds is checking in. I remember deep in the... Oh yeah. Sorry. Yeah, Laura Deeds is just saying back in the COVID days, I was writing quite a bit of tunes. But yeah, this Noelle came over and we hit it off real good. And by golly, now we're buying a house together and started a life together. It's beautiful. So, my God... All right. What was I going to do here? I did have something in mind. I got distracted thinking about Noelle. Something you haven't heard before. Is it possible? Glenn, funny that you mention it. I wrote... that's Noelle's lips. I actually had this thing, man, when I started sort of improving my life over the last bunch of years... last like 4 years or so, I actually kind of felt bad. I'll Tree of Life, I'll do that for you, Laura Deeds. I felt guilty about like being healthy, and like because I have a lot of friends, and I was one of them for most you know, I still am, you know. I say whatever, I'm a degenerate at heart, you know. I don't want to put it that way, but you know, how do I put it? I didn't want to feel like I was rubbing it in anybody's face by saying, "Hey, look how well I'm doing," you know? I always felt like there were people probably in the gutters thinking, "You son of a bitch." You know, and I used to, you know, I've had a lot of times in my life I've been down in the dumps and down in a hole. And just looking at people that were doing well in healthy relationships and being like, F you, you know, you. And it's not a healthy way to be. But yeah, I don't know. I don't know where I'm trying to go with that, but I guess there's that problem with the mic again. Sorry about the... Oof. Sorry about the pop in your ear there. I'll mute it next time I have to do that. I'll try to figure out what that problem is. But anyway, Yeah, I don't know. It was mostly stopping the drinking and the cocaine. That really started turning things around. But anyway, I love my fucked up friends, though. That's the thing, you know? I never wanted to be, it always rubbed me the wrong way, seeing people that would give up the booze or whatever and then totally become a holy roller and, you know, I don't know, man. I don't know what I'm trying to say. Let's just play some songs. I like that you guys drink. I don't mind, you know. I don't like when people change their behavior around me either, because they're like tiptoe around the sobriety thing. Like, oh, I didn't want to drink in front of you. I was like, fucking drink up. You know? What the hell was I going to do? Oh, yeah. Glenn asked for a new song. I wrote three new songs over the last few weeks. I wanted to write some more danceable type tunes here. And let me see if I can connect my phone to these are like demo versions that I recorded. I did a few demo versions of three new songs. Would you like to hear them? I think I can connect my phone to the mixing board here via Bluetooth. Okay. So here we go. Let's see if this works. It should. We're connected to the Model 24. Unmute the channel. All right, are you ready? I have three of them on here. Maybe. All right. I can't sign you in. Oh, wait, here we go. All right. Do you want to hear Borderline Insane? The Rabbit Race? The Rabbit and the Turtle. I don't know what I'm going to name that one yet. Or You Make My Fire Fly. Let's do... See, I'm going to play this one first. Called You Make My Fire Fly. All right. I hope you enjoy it. I hope I can play it through here. I think I can. Shut the reverb off. All right. Here we go. Let me this is our little demo version. So this is my version that I'm going to show the rest of the band the song and then start learning it from there. You know what's funny? The rest of the band hasn't even heard this yet. Bobby Pickett has not heard this yet, or Clarky has not heard this yet. You like the Rabbit Race? You want to hear the Rabbit Race? Bobby Weir, let's start with that one. Let's start with the Rabbit Race. Rabbit. All right, Martha. Martha, you convinced me. All right, ready? This one's called the Rabbit Race.
The track looked good, and the weather was looking fine. A curious crowd of creatures gather round to see the curious race. They all know there can be no way a turtle can keep the rabbit's pace. Hot tamale is a classic race, one burning hot and one keeping pace. The rabbit and the turtle in the starting space, we all end up in the finishing place. Oh, and he's favoring the rabbit. Easy money looks good, and they all want to grab it. But the road is full of twists, and the road is full of hurdles. A rabbit looks fast and fit, but my money's on the turtle. At the money, it's a classic race, one burning hot and one keeping pace. The rabbit and the turtle in the starting space, we all end up in the finishing place. Oh, they all heard the starting gun, but the rabbit was the only one hopping up and starting to run, while the turtle was having fun. But the road is full of twists, and the road is full of hurdles. The rabbit is fast and fit, but my money's on the turtle. Hot tamale, it's a classic race, one burning hot and one keeping pace. The rabbit and the turtle in the starting space, we all end up in the finishing place. Oh, oh. As luck would have it, lightning flashed and it began to rain. In his tracks stopped the rabbit, turtle swam and it began to gain. Roads turned to mud, the rabbit was getting skittish. But the turtle of the flood rode the wave to the finish. Hot tamale, it's a classic race, one burning hot and one keeping pace. The rabbit and the turtle in the starting space, we all meet up at the finishing place. Hot tamale, it's a classic race, one burning hot and one keeping pace. The rabbit and the turtle in the starting place, we all end up at the finishing place. Oh, 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 oh.
And there you have it. Turtle, the rabbit race. All right, that's a new one. Okay. Yeah, baby. You know what? I was inspired by the song. I love that tune by Arrow. Caribbean band. Trinidad. That one is in, yes, it's in B flat, correct. In F or B, yeah. 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 I think it's in F. Alrighty. Oh, thanks. So yeah, that was a debut there. I have two other ones. I'll share them in a minute, though. We'll do some live music, and then we'll do some of those. No, those are just I haven't really I recorded those right here, with the guitar and the bass, and programming the drums on the computer. So those are, No, I wrote that one. I played the guitar and the bass on that. On all of these. These next bunch here. I got one. Let's do it. This is a song I like to play down here. I learned this one over the last couple years, and I see Donnell in the chat, and I know she's a fan of this tune, so let me do this one for you. Hold on. Song called You Got a Friend. Thank you.
you're down and trouble, and you need a helping hand, and nothing, oh, nothing is going right. Just close your eyes and think of me. Soon I will be there to brighten up even your darkest night. You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you again. All winter, spring, summer, or fall, all you got to do is call, and I'll be there. Yeah, 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 yeah. You've got a friend.
Another friend. Oh, okay. Oh, maybe I'll see you later then. No? Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. Housekeeping. Housekeeping. Okay.
Housekeeping.
All right. Well, that was nice. That's a nice one. That's right. Randy and Martha came over. I forget what you guys were even coming over to. I don't know if I was borrowing something or you were borrowing something or what was going on there, but yeah, I stuck the thing at the end of a basket on a pole. And this is during COVID, you know, we're supposed to stay 5.5 feet apart, whatever it was. We had to stay so many inches apart. That was goddamn ridiculous. All right. Now, what are we going to do next? Oh, I got one for you. Laura Dees. We used to do this one on the show. I learned this one during COVID. Actually, I used to play it back in high school, but then it became relevant again. Excuse me. I should hit the sneeze button for that. Sorry about that. Okay. Let's see how this one goes. So ridiculous. What? Oh, my version of that song? Bless you. Oh, thank you, Glenn. I was waiting for one of you guys to bless me. Appreciate You've got a friend. Yeah, person's like, I love that when they, sometimes people do that on Facebook or whatever. They'll, you know, make a point to let everyone know that they're lonely and they really need a friend. And then all these people reach out to them and they're like, well, no, not you. I wanted this one specific person to reach out that's never going to reach out, but not all you people. My God. I thought you needed a friend. Well, not you. All right. I'm going to try to appreciate all our friends here. Had a dream. If God sneezed, what are you supposed to say? Yeah, when St. Anthony loses shit, who do you pray to? You know, who does he pray to? That reminds me of the Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. I bought that book for River. That was one of, I used to enjoy that one. That's one of the books I read when I was a janitor back in my in high school and middle school. I was a janitor at my middle school over the summer as my summer job. I would read books in the closet and hide in the library and read books. But they were all middle school books. All right. Oh, that's great.
That's great. Starts with an earthquake. Birds, snakes, and aeroplane. Lenny Bruce is not afraid. Eye of a hurricane, listen to yourself churn. World serves its own needs, don't serve your own needs. Speed it up at night, speed and grunt, no strength. No ladder starts to clatter with fear. Fight, wire in a fire, representing seven games in a for hiring a combat site.
I can do better. I can do better now. Hold on.
That's great. Starts with an earthquake. Birds, snakes, and aeroplane. Lenny Bruce is not afraid. I have a hurricane, listen to yourself, churn world, serves its own needs, don't misserve your own needs, speed it up and not speed and grunt, no strength, no ladder, starts a cloud with fear of high down, high wire in a fire, representing seven games in a government for hire, in a combat site, left the west, coming in the hurries with the beers breathing down your neck. Team of team reporters baffled Trump, tethered crap, look at that low plane, fine, then overflow, population common movement, it'll do, save yourself, serve yourself, world serves its own needs, listen to your heartbeat, tell me with eruption and the reverend and the right, right you, vitriolic, patriotic, slam, fight, bright light, feeling pretty psyched, it's the end of the world as we know it, it's
lesson, our Monday evening history lesson here. Okay, I'm going to teach you about the War of 1812, and more importantly, more specifically, the Battle of New Orleans, which took place in 1814, led by Colonel Andrew Jackson, Old Hickory, as they used to call him, one of our most bloodthirsty presidents. All right. He was a trailblazer, Old Andrew Jackson. The Trail of Tears. Okay. All right, let's do it. I had the opportunity to play this song right across from Jackson Square down in New Orleans last month. All right. Andrew Jackson, I hope you like what they did for you here. Let me tell you guys about it. 1814, we took a little trip along with Colonel Jackson down the mighty Mississippi. Took a little bacon and we took a little beans. They caught the bloody British in the town of New Orleans. Fired our guns in the British empty commons. Wasn't quite as many as there was a while ago. Fired once more and they began running down the Mississippi to the Gulf of Mexico. Mm-hmm.
among a hundred of them beating on a drum. Stepped so high and they made the bugles ring. We stood beside a cotton field, we did not say a thing. Fired our guns and the British kept it coming. Wasn't quite as many as there was a while ago. I fired once more and they began running down the Mississippi into the Gulf of Mexico. Hickory said we could take him by surprise if we didn't fire muskets till we looked him in the eyes. Held our fire till we seen their faces well and opened up our squirrel guns and really gave them will. We fired our guns and the British kept it coming. Wasn't quite as many as there was a while ago. Fired once more and they began a running down the Mississippi into the Gulf of Mexico. Okay, we've come to the final verse that everybody loves. I don't know if this last verse is true or not, but man, I love the idea of using reptiles as artillery. Laura, you don't like it? I think Laura feels bad for the alligator in this verse. They ran out of ammo. What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do? Sign a peace treaty? All right, here we go. Well, we fired our cannon till the barrel melted down. So we grabbed an alligator and we pulled another round. Filled his head with cannonballs and powdered his behind. When we torched the powder off, a gator blew his mind. Fired our guns and the British kept it coming. Was a cottonman, yes, there was a while ago. We fired once more and they began to run it down to Mississippi to go for Mexico. Well, we fired our guns and the British kept it coming. Yes, it was a while ago. Five once more, and they begin to run it down the Mississippi to the Gulf of Mexico. Oh. Arriba! Viva la Mexico! Mexico. Yeah. All right. The old Battle of New Orleans. Yeah, you're right, Laura Deez. I think that peace treaty was already signed at that point. The war was technically over. But Andrew Jackson said, we don't care. You want to hear another new song?
Check this one out.
I'm going to start this one and I might go over there for a second. All right. This one's called You Make My Firefly. All right. Check this one out. Think you might like this one. Now, this one, I'm not even sure what it's exactly about. Some of the words are definitely inspired by Noel, and then some are inspired by River's favorite show, One Piece. I don't know. I songs like this next one, I won't even explain it anymore. I'll just you got to read the lyrics if you're into it. I like when people kind of, I like leaving it open ended enough to you can kind of put your own meaning to it. All right, You Make My Firefly. Here we go. Check this one out. This is a new one, hot off the press. Hot off the Mac Logic.
hot off Logic Pro. My studio. All right, here we go. No, I'm just talking. Well, I get nervous showing you guys new tunes, you know? Here you go. K. Billy's Sounds of the 70s. That's a new one. You make my firefly. You make my firefly. Yes, you do. Indeed. All right. Hope you enjoy that one. These are still, so like, don't share these around because these are only for you guys right here. We got to, you know, those, these are like the demo versions. That's, I just do a quick look. Well, thanks, Kim. All right, one of our favorite things that one of the coolest things that came from. Yeah. Good beach song, right on. one of the cool things that came out of the Spirit Elevator show, and like labeling the days as Moody Monday and this or that. Well, Twisted Tunes Day was one of my favorites, where we would well, I don't know why I'm putting it in the past tense. It's still, we still do it. okay. Twisted Tunes Day, where we take the songs and kind of strip them down and build them back up in a different, and put different clothes on them. And we dress them up different and take them out for a spin. And a lot of creative stuff comes out of Twisted Tunes Day. And this is now my favorite version of this song. This is one that came out of our Twisted Tunes Day.
Dancing is honest.
dreaming to cease. Preaching is vain, laughter release. Now just because the cookie crumble, and don't change the way the cookie tastes. Sometimes sticky will get greasy, or sometimes sticky gets replaced. Just a little setback, we'll make a new plan of attack. We're gonna hit them off at the path. Put the train on track, shopping in my life, and laying down my gun. We're gonna have some fun tonight. We're gonna have some fun tonight. Well, the comedy is the truth, and the magic is the lies. Had love can be such pain, but the music can revive. When a cookie crumble, I don't change the way the cookie tastes. Sometimes freaky will get greasy, or sometimes freaky gets replaced. You know, you're just a little setback, but I never fade to black. With all the ace thing, king of ten, doing a jack. Moving ahead by stepping back, with addition by subtraction. It's my kind of math on. Thank you, Kim.
Yeah, a little lowdown version of that. Cool. Yeah, baby. Well, all right. Hey, this has been a fun night, huh? So this is a fun night. Moody Monday. Moody Monday's always been one of the funnest. They've all got their but often Moody Monday did its job, where I'd come in here kind of worn out. I was working this morning too. I started a new job today, doing a house in Springfield. So I dropped off a bunch of stuff this morning at the new house, and went over and started working on this house in Springfield. I got home. I heated up a couple slices of pizza, and I took a little power nap there and got up to do the show. Mattoon Street. I don't know if I can do Mattoon Street. We're going to do other songs, Martha. Tree of Life. Somebody asked for Tree of Life. We got to do a Biggie song. In fact, I'll do a couple Biggie tunes. I have all the... Look, I'll show you on this. Let me get the camera angle for you. Oh. Yeah, here you go. All these papers over here on the ground. This is all the stuff that was in the file cabinet. And back then, I would have, when I had people come over to play... Oh, man. We got to give a shout out to our friend Brad. Our friend Brad from Canada. Look, this is a packet that he sent. He sent maybe a year or so ago. I guess I should reread some of these things. I still talk to Brad now and again. A little shout out. He often catches the shows in the future these days. But, so one of the neatest things about doing this show is just you never know who you know, who's gonna see it and who we're gonna move down here, you know. And became friends with this dude Brad. I like you, Brad. He's a good dude, and we still keep in touch. He's off his rocker, but a lot of us, you know. I don't even know where that rocker is anymore. We're so far off the rocker. So Brad, I just want to say thanks, man. Thanks for being a part of the show since the beginning. But that's not what I was looking for. Here's more stuff from Brad. But then I would... Oh, here's Mark Mercier's file. We can do a Mark Mercier tune. Oh, lost the camera. Hold on. We'll fix that right away. Oh, show must be going long. The batteries are dying. There's Tom Coburn's file. See, I had a file for each person and their songs. I'd write down their songs before playing them, and then I'd keep them on file, like the FBI, like the musical FBI. All right, let's see here. Tree of Life, and then maybe a Biggie. Maybe we'll do a deeper cut. I'd like to do an Ain't the Greatest Life. Is one of my faves. Oh, here's all my files. I put them up here. Here's my stack of files. Look, we got Mark Morris. All their music is in here too. Eli Elkis. I haven't talked to Eli in a long time. Phil Crouch, Philly Joe Crouch. Great guitar player. Callie. I gotta get Callie back down. Look at Ben Bowen. Zach Dengzinger, Jay Hamilton, Chris Spillane. Chris Spillane is a great story here. I'm looking through the file. These are like I got the names of these people's files, and then they'd come over, and for a couple hours we'd spend a couple hours like going over their tunes, and I'd write notes, and I'd keep them in these files, so the next time they come over we didn't have to start from zero again, you know. But Chris Belain was supposed to come over, and I learned some of these songs, and he was planning on coming over, and he called me like either the night before or the morning of, and he's like, "Oh, Jeff, I can't get for I've." Some he had some valid reason he couldn't make it. I was like, no problem. And then and instead Noel came over, and so I just like to thank Chris Belain for not showing up that day, because that really worked out. Brother Sal, we did a show down here with Brother Sal, remember? We brought the whole drum set down here. Ed was playing with us, Ed Ballin, Dan LaFave. We did his songs, his like 90s rock tunes, Night, The Wild Gypsies, oh no, they're not together anymore, Katie and Steven, Bobby Pickett, of course Bobby Pickett, that's, you know what, we got together with Bobby Pickett, joined the band over the last couple of years, well, of course, I mean, all of it really, I mean, obviously the King Sazen started during the Spirit Elevator. And then Martha, look, we got Joe Ramage here. We got Joe Ramage, who taught me a lot of these deeper cuts of the of Bob Weir's songs. Brother Sal is so good, huh? I wish I could have seen. He just played at Theodore's a couple weeks ago. Yeah. So just wanted a little shout out for all the musician friends that have joined me over here over the last bunch of years. And we will continue to do that. We'll continue that tradition. What was I going to do? Oh, yeah. It's a long way from home. It's a long, long way from home. It's a long, long way to roam. No one ever had to tell me I was like a rolling stone. It's a sunny, sunny day. No one here to stay with me, so I'll be on my way. It's Jeffrey, hold on. Where's he go to? It's going to the century, and I still hold on to the memories. C sharp minor, B, F sharp major, E. All right, we're going to do a couple more songs tonight and call it a night. I'm gonna do this song by Big Mike Pellerin, The Tree of Life. If I find my other notebook, I'd like to do it. Oh, there it is, it's over there. Hang on, there's two songs I wanna do by Biggie. For those listening in the future, apologize for breaking up the continuity here. But, oh, that ain't the greatest life, although that one's cool too. Oh man. It's not it either. It's not in here. Where did it go? Oh well, all right. Oh well. It's getting late anyway. We're going to do... We'll do more of Biggie's songs next time. This is Big Mike Pellerin's song called Tree of Life. Biggie, thanks for the music, man. Big Mike Pellerin was a good friend of ours. They used to play these songs out on the streets of Northampton, sometimes down in Springfield.
Tree of life is high. Water tastes...
God damn it. Excuse me.
It's a long, long way from home. It's a long, long way to roam. No one here to stay with me.
Jesus, Jeff.
It's a long, long way from home. It's a long, long way to roam. No one ever had to tell me I was like a rolling stone. It's a sunny, sunny day. No one here to stay with me, so I'll be on my way. Walking through the willows, smiling at the sun. I close my window so I can't see that there's anything wrong. Tastes like wine. I got all my friends around me and I'm really feeling fine. Tree of life is high. The water tastes like wine. I got all my friends around me and I'm really feeling fine. Tree of life is high. Water tastes like wine. I have all my friends around me. I'm really feeling fine. Tree of life is high. Water tastes like wine. I have all my friends around me and I'm really feeling fine. Feeling fine.
interesting. Yeah, big Mike Pellerin, thank you for the music, my friend. Love you, dude. Love you, I miss you. Tony Phoenix says, when is the new elevator going to be complete? How about doing a little time lapse of the construction? Yeah, that's not a bad idea. I could show you the process of putting things together. There's not much construction more than, assembly. Just got to put things back together, take things apart, and put them together again. You want to hear another new song? We're going to wrap up the show in a minute here. But I promised you three new songs, and I played you two of them. So that means we got one left. If my math is right. Yeah, Noel. Noel's That's right. I have Chris Spillane to thank for Noel and I's relationship starting. I have Chris Spillane to thank for not showing up that day. And I also have Colette and Louis to thank. Colette is Noelle's sister, and brother-in-law is Louis. Because, yeah, her car broke down on the way here, her 94 Honda Civic. Kicked the bucket, or as I like to say, shit the bed. Oh, she says kicked the bed. Oh, that's a nice way to put it. Yeah, so I was like, oh, man, Noelle's not going to come here. And I was internally really bummed out. But her sister and Louis showed up to the rescue. I was like, wow, that is a really nice family that she did that for you. That was the first time I met Noelle's sister. It was funny. She was telling me that I had forgotten about this, but she goes, yeah, my sister was going to pick you up. And I immediately started cleaning up the house and stuff. Try to make it look presentable for the family. All right. Well, I'm really glad you made it. All right, I'm going to do one more song. This is like a new demo song that I haven't even shared this with our band yet. So I just kind of put these demos together. I played the bass and the guitar and sang these ones, and I made the drums on the computer. I did these in Logic Pro on the Mac. That's what we use for our Spirit Elevator home studio. This song's called Borderline Insane. It's a song about, I was just kind of thinking about how weird it is, how there's like an island in other parts of the world too. One of the first places I noticed like huge division of rich and poor with like one line down the middle. I was working in Louisiana in Mandeville, which is a really rich town on the other side of Lake Pontchartrain. You have New Orleans down here, then there's Lake Pontchartrain, and above it is Mandeville. I was working at Sweet Daddy's Cajun Barbecue. The owner of Sweet Daddy's Cajun Barbecue was also the vice president of Bumblebee Tuna. Huge corporation. And so he had, he kind of built this restaurant as like, something for his wife and daughter to do. So run a restaurant in Mandeville. But the people working there, they were all up and down the spectrum. And like Miss Shirley and her son, damn, I wish I could remember his name, but it was 24 years ago. But I would bring them home from work sometimes. And you're going through Mandeville, and it's all gated communities. And I think Oprah Winfrey. No, it wasn't Oprah Winfrey. Who's the other one? Who's that other heavy lady who had a talk show? Rosie O'Donnell had a place there, I think, in Mandeville. Was it Rosie O'Donnell? It doesn't matter. One of those ladies with a television show had her house there in Mandeville. And anyway, I'm just kind of telling you how well-to-do this area was. And then you cross the line into Lacombe, and all the, you know, the cars are up on blocks, and it's just, it's it goes from super rich to super poor, like, as you cross the line. I was thinking of the island, Dominican Republic and Haiti, and how wild it is, how crazy it is, how kind of developed that way. We're just a line down the middle of this island where it's complete insanity on one side and like resort hotels on the other side. And anyway, so this song's called Borderline Insane. Oh, I had Noel sang. I've been wanting to do this for a while. It was like write parts for the other members of the band, you know, so like, just because it's my song, like I want to write stuff for, you know, have Noel do a singing part too. Things like that. Anyway, you'll get the idea when you hear it. Noel sings the chorus on this one. I come in with the verses. All right. Enough background. Let's listen to this one. And then we'll play Alice, and then we're going to say goodnight, and we'll see you on the other side. We're going to have to say goodnight, say goodbye to this lovely studio. Bobby Pickett, also, by the way, I got thank Bobby big time for, he would come over when we were first starting this out, and he was always a huge helping hand. Whenever he saw I was getting something going on, he's like, "Oh, I'll be over there to help you out." So he helped out with this getting the monitor, our television monitor. I brought the television from upstairs. I used the nice TV down here as our monitor, and. Yeah, Bobby helped with that and helped with just other things around here, all the, you know, getting hooks up. The electricity, wiring the place better. When I first started out, I just had extension cords hanging everywhere and all over the place. And, you know, Bobby made it more legit. I sheetrocked his ceiling over the last couple of years. So, actually, during this next song, I'll spin the camera around, show you what we got. It's funny. It's there's still a lot of stuff down here, but it's all the studio things. But to me, it looks kind of empty. All right, let me play this song. I'll swing the camera around while this song is going on. You can see. I'll show you a view of the studio. All right. Without further ado. The song's called Borderline Insane. Check it out.
Whoops.
Okay. So that's that tune. Did the camera stop? Did the camera shut the audio off too, or I don't know what the heck I did. Well, I hit a button. I hit a button. Wasn't supposed to hit. All right. So that was the third new song, Borderline Insane. All right. So those songs will be coming along and will be developing, and I'm going to show those to the band. And the audio was going the whole time. Okay, good. As long as the audio did not kick the bucket with the video, that's all right. All right. Last song. It's already almost 10 o'clock. Holy cow. Quite a show. Thank you guys, everybody. I really... I say it often, but I still don't, maybe not. I don't think I can say it often enough how much I appreciate and thank you guys for being here and appreciating the music and showing up to the live shows, which the next one is this Thursday at Rooftop. Noelle and I are doing a duo show. All right. And, of course, if you want to leave a tip for the Spirit Elevator Studio, the Venmo and PayPal information is in the description. And make sure you're subscribed to the channel. And we'll see you in the new elevator. All right. Thanks, everyone. So we'll see you next time. Kim, have no fear. The elevator is not going anywhere. We're just changing keys. All right. I thought of that joke during that last song. All right. So God bless everybody. We'll see you next time. Tony, love you, man. All right. And thank everybody for being a part of the show. Cha-cha-cha indeed, Laura. All right. Till next time, everybody, which won't be too long. I'm hoping to be up and running by next Monday. All right. All right. If you want to catch the band live, you can see us at the rooftop on Thursday. Okay. Peace out, everybody.